regular basis. Did you know that Australians eat about 30 kilos of beef per person each year? Well, unsurprisingly, our beef industry is worth about $18 billion. But wastage throughout the food chain can lead to lost revenue for everyone involved. As an epidemiologist, my goal is to investigate a disease that leads to wastage of meat product and is believed to be costing the beef industry a big chunk of money. You might have heard of it. It can infect and kill you. It's called hydatid disease. Hydatid disease is caused by a parasite, or more technically a tapeworm. It lives in the gut of dogs and produces thousands of eggs that spread throughout the environment via the feces of the dog. Then a cow comes along and eats some of this contaminated grass, unknowingly consuming some of the eggs. Once inside, the eggs make their way to the various organs where they gradually develop into fluid-filled hydatid cysts. Luckily, unlike in us, hydatid disease is rarely fatal in livestock. In fact, it generally goes unnoticed until slaughter. But it's here where the most evident wastage occurs. Any organ found to be infected with hydatid cysts is either thrown out or at the very least downgraded to pet food. And Australian abattoirs are regularly finding organs of cattle infected with hydatid cysts. Let me give you some numbers. In 2015, a pilot study found that one abattoir threw out more than 150 tonnes of beef product just due to hydatid cysts. Based on my calculations, that could be more than 5,000 tonnes from the whole industry in a year. Not only this, the study also identified another form of waste. This was in the form of reduced weights of infected animals, and this led to a combined loss of more than $1.7 million to that one abattoir in 1 year. But reduced weights don't just impact the abattoir. They also impact the prices paid to the farmer for their cattle. So imagine how much money farmers in hydatid-prone areas could be losing as a result of this disease. Now, these results do need clarification and refinement, and they bring up more questions like, where are these cattle coming from? And what can we do to reduce this waste and increase profit? And that's what I'm here for. I'm going to identify where these cattle are coming from and look at the main reasons as to why they are becoming infected in these areas. I'm also going to look into the reduced weight situation and estimate the current major losses to the Australian beef industry. With this information, the beef industry will be able to target their control strategies and look into the financial viability of producing a vaccine for this disease that could significantly reduce the number of infected organs thrown out at slaughter. They may only be small steps, but they are key steps in not only understanding hydatid disease, but also fighting the war on waste in our beef industry. Thank you.